Well, remember that Dave's Farm rocket we said we built last weekend? Sky is beautiful, air is warm, the women are hot too, and no wind, so it's a perfect day to set her off. So I got a trunk load of wood, and I've made a little tripod to set it on so it doesn't sit right in the fire and heat up those fins and bend them. All the fins have a little curve on them so that the thing will spin in the air. We'll have a straighter trajectory, I hope. That's if it blows out the bottom like we're planning it doing. Let me show you how it works. It's just water in here and a modified valve. Just about 2 gallons of water in here. So I've got a little cut part way through, and hopefully this acts as a nozzle and directs the steam as it's coming out. And the last time we used just a half-size propane tank and 4 liters of water, and we got 500 feet. Now we've got about 8, 9, 10 liters of water in there. A little bit bigger container. So let's see if we get a big bang and how many feet we're going to get. At least from 3 camera angles. Cool. There she is on her stilts. Let's make a fire. We're all set. I got my Boy Scout skills in action, and we're ready to ignite. Now I'm assuming it's going to take a minimum of 20 minutes before it goes off, so we don't have to run too quick. We can stand around and have a couple beer, scratch our balls, whatever. Look out, she's going to blow!
Quick launch, boom!
Alrighty, we're 1 kilometer from the nearest building, so I don't think anybody has to worry about falling shrapnel.
I'll go get the camera set up and
we'll
see if you watch
it. Nice knowing you. You've been a good long friend.
Okay, fellow astronauts, we're going to the launch pad.
We're launching our rocket for the moon. We're at NASA, Dave's Farm, NASA.
Gotta get like the hell out of here. Get far away. Steam.
It's steam.
Everybody's watching. Nothing but sit back and wait and see if this thing goes off. Cool. Do we have spectators? Do we have spectators?
Oh yeah.
Well, are you going to sit up here or sit in there and get more protection?
This is more protection.
Come on, you've never lived, you've almost died.
It's also warm.
So it's warm up there, get near that fire. Holy God! Oh wow! It didn't go very high, but it went sideways.
Certainly did.
Is that ever loud? Oh!
Look up!
Is there still a piece that's going to come down? Well, it went near the fence line. Well, let's go look at the peripheral and collateral damage. My fire! Oh, look at that. The rebars we had holding it up are all bent and mangled. Cool. No fire left.
That was a damn good fire, too.
Now we gotta look. Where'd all the wood go? Well, we gotta find it. We gotta find the smoking gun. Need a pair, anyone? Well, that rocket sure was a fail, wasn't it? Well, we did manage to find a couple pieces. There's part of the side. Well, as you've seen, the tank blew up. It didn't really fly. None of the welds broke that held on the fins, although I haven't found any fins yet, and we had a lot of people looking. There's the bottom. There's that hole I cut out. Funny thing is, everything blew up at the same time. It blew out the thrust hole, and the sides all ripped apart, and then the half-round top, it went flying away, and we're still looking for that. Interestingly, it had so much downforce that a rebar that we were standing on punched right through the metal. Another rebar totally split this thrust tube. It split it right open. And the third rebar didn't it here. Wow. Just for rough old rebars to punch through that metal must have been a couple thousand pounds of thrust, that's for sure. Easy. Good thing we were so far away. Very dangerous.
Don't try this at home, boys and girls, and when I find the rest of the pieces, I'll get them on camera and let you see them too.